And amen. We will ride off the scriptures that were said by other ministers. And just to take a simple thought, I want you to just shelter in this place. Joshua was talking to the people of Israel, understanding that they had picked up some bad habits. They had picked up some viruses, if you will. They had picked up some things that they had to put down. And the only way he could get them to understand and get back to their true and living God, he had them to shelter in this place. If you understand what's going on in today's society, if you look down there in San Francisco, the mayor and the city officials told everybody to shelter in their own place. Go back home and shelter. Get away from the virus. Get away from the things that you may pick up. So in this time, you might can't come to church, but I'm asking you to shelter in that place. What Joshua was saying was, don't worry about what we've been through. You gotta shelter in the place. You gotta come back home and get back to the foundations. Yes, Reverend Waddell said, are you praying with your children? It's time to shelter in this place. Are you studying your word? It's time to shelter in this place. Are you praying for yourself? It's time to shelter in this place, because at this time in our lives, we cannot afford to step back. We cannot afford to let loose. We have to hold on to God's unchanging hands. So what Joshua understood was, though we have picked up some bad viruses, and we can just shelter in the place, after a while, God is going to clean us up. He's going to straighten us out. We're going to be able to get to a quiet place to hear his voice. I wish somebody will understand it's time to shelter in the place that God provided. It's time to shelter in the things that God has done. It's time to shelter in every blessing, in everything that you're going through. It is time to shelter. So at the end of the day, Joshua said, it's time for you to make a decision. What you gonna do? Because if you've been through this before, you understand that trouble don't last always. Because trouble don't last always, you got to pick out what you're going to do. And Joshua said it so eloquently. He said, as for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. And I like the word serve, because it was an action word. He won't go at home to do nothing. He won't go at home to stay quiet. He wasn't going home to put his hands up under his backside. Well, he said, I'm going home to get with my God, and I will serve him the best way I can. So mamas, serve God. Daddies, serve God. Children, serve God.